Welcome to the React Game Challenge. In this challenge, we will design a game, learn and write code for React.js components, make the app responsive for desktop and mobile users, learn and write code for React states and props, and deploy the web game app online. In the previous video, we have made our application dynamic by adding functionality to the buttons. And in this video, we are going to animate our UI elements so that users can get visual feedback when they click a button. If you have come directly to this video, I will highly recommend that you watch the previous videos first to get the context of what we are doing. If you have watched the previous videos, let's resume the challenge. My name is Aditya Shenoy from Brainy Things, where I make programming simple and fun. Today's first challenge is to click the subscribe button. Only 20% of people who watch my videos are able to complete this challenge. If you are not subscribed and would like to watch my videos in future, I will appreciate it if you click the subscribe button. Oh, I forgot to mention that there are bonus points to this challenge if you click the like button as well. For animating the hand image, I need access to hand.css, and I can write the animation directly over here, but there is a catch. I don't want that animation to start when I click the refresh button or this page is loaded for the first time. I want that animation to be dynamic. That is, when the user clicks one of these buttons, the state should change. The animation state should change. So I'm using the correct words because I want to include that animation as a property. As a state. So animate as false. So currently, initially, this hand should not animate. So I'm setting that to false. Even in reset, this should be false. So even if the animation is going on, if we click the reset button, this should be reset to false. But when I click the button, this function is called perform move. So I want the animation to start. So what I can do is I can, once this button is clicked, as soon as this button is clicked, I can set state, and I can set this to animate true. And what animation I'm planning to do, just like we play the stone paper scissors in actual game, for example, this is our hand. If we want to play stone paper scissors, we do not perform the move directly. We do this stone paper scissors, and then we open our hands or keep our hands closed based on whatever we want to do. So this is the exact animation that we want to do. So 1, 2, and 3, and this animation should start when we click the button. And even if we choose to open our hands for paper, we want the animation initial image to be stone. Similarly for this. So when this button is called, I want the state, both the images of user move should be stone user, and comp move should be stone, like this. And this should be temporary. If I do this, this is not doing anything now because it is instantly setting this to stone user and then setting this to whatever value it was. So we want to add some delay, and for that I will do set timeout. Okay, before that, let's define the CSS for this, the animation. Inside our hand.js, we can pass a class name of hand double hyphens animate. This is a BEM convention again. This is different than what we are doing for other things like this. So double underscore is an element inside a block, but in this case, we are not putting an element inside a block. We are modifying, putting a modifier for this block. So this is the convention of the block name, double hyphens, and the modifier that we want to put. So hand animate. But if we put this, and if we add hand animate animation over here, it will start animation as soon as the application starts. So we don't want that. So we want this hand animate to be added to this class name when this state of animate is true. So again, we are using the property, we are passing this animate property through our app.js parent component. So I will pass animate equal to this dot state dot animate, and if I do this, the hand.js will know whether it should start the animation or not. So this is conditional. So I will just cut this and I will add this hand animate, and as you can see, the color is not correct. That shows that I'm doing something wrong. Initially it was a simple text, and so I did not need to include that inside curly brace, but now I'm using some JavaScript expressions over here, so I need to include that inside curly brace. Yes, the color now looks good. So hand animate, I want to add this with the space behind when props.animate is true. If props.animate is true, this string will get added to this, but if it is false, I don't want any other class. So in the else part, I will add empty string, so nothing will change over here. So this is a ternary operator or conditional operator. This is a boolean and props.animate. If this is true, this will be returned, else this will be returned, and one of these will be added to the original hand class. And this is not an ID and this is a class, so this can contain multiple class names. So in our hand.css, we can style this hand animation separately than our hand, the original hand thing. So inside our hand.css, I will put the class name that I had just defined, hand double hyphen animate, and I will put animation, and I will give the animation name as hand animation, which we will define in just a moment. And this animation should result should be run for a second. So this hand animation should run for 1 second for this class. Let's define this animation. For defining an animation, we have to do keyframes, @keyframes, the name of the keyframe animations, and inside this we want to define what needs to be performed in a specific frame, the keyframe. So the start is defined by from. So initially the hand should be over here, like its position should not change. We are just changing the Y coordinate like this. So initially it should be like this. Then it should go up. Then it should go down. Then it should go down again. Then it should go up, up, and then finally down. So stone, paper, scissors, like this. So these are the keyframes. So this is one keyframe. This is one keyframe. Ideally, we do not need to put this keyframe, but still, for uniformity, we will put this. This is a keyframe, this is a keyframe, this is a keyframe, and then finally, this is the final keyframe. So you will understand this pattern once we write this. So we want to transform the translation of Y. We are just translating the hand in the Y direction. So translate Y. Initially, it will be 0. It should start from the original position. And so let's count the keyframes. So this is original one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 keyframes, but the first keyframe will be starting from 0%. So I need to divide this by 6. So this will result to 16%, almost 16%. So I will put multiples of 16 in our keyframes. So over here, the first keyframe is like this. So this from is analogous to 0%. Then 16%, I want my hand to go up. And I can put minus negative values inside this to go up. So I will do 5 viewport height. And we'll just copy this. And for 32%, I want this to go back to 0 again. Then for 48%, I want this to go to positive 5 viewport height, that is a little below the original position. Then for 64%, I want this back at 0. 80%, this is correct, minus 5 viewport height. And then finally 2, back to its original position, that is 0. What this will do is, as you can see, the pattern 0, minus 5, 0, 5, 0, minus 5, 0. And this is exactly what this motion will be. 0, minus 5, 0, 5, 0, minus 5, 0. And you can see that this is not exactly 16% difference. This is 80% and this is 100%. So this should have a difference of 20%. But we are dividing 1 second interval into these intervals. So 20% of 20 and 16, like 4% of 1 second, that difference. So we do not need to stress on that. So once this is done, if we go to our app and do this, you can see the animation has started for once, but just once. So we need to fix this logic, but this is exactly what we want. But as you can see, the image is instantly changing. We wanted that to be stone for a second, and then we wanted to change this image. So over here in our app.js, once we set this animation to true, we want to keep this animation for a second. So what we can do this is, we can define a separate function, animate hands, and instead of calling this perform move directly, I will call animate hands. You will come to know why I am doing this in just a second, with a parameter, and this should take a parameter of move, and this functionality should be inside this. So what we are doing this, we have not changed anything. We are just calling this animate hands, and we are animating this. And we want to keep this state for a second. So I can use the set timeout function, that calls a function after a specific amount of time. So set timeout, inside this, I will pass an arrow function. And I can directly call this perform move with the original move that I have just passed, and do this functionality. So this perform move should be called after a second, that is 1000 milliseconds, like this. Let's see what this is going to do. Okay, this should be this dot perform move. Okay, this is working. I reset this. As you can see, even if I click this scissors button, the stone image will remain the same for a second and then the hand opens. I have not changed that for a computer, I suppose. So let's fix that. Yes. So I need to pass the same animate property over here. So this will do now. But this animation is happening for just one time because we are setting this animation to be true, but we are not resetting that to false. So we need to change that. And there is a possibility that if I click paper and then reset, as you can see, the animation was still going on. So we need to change that. So instead of directly calling this perform move, I want to check first whether I still need to animate this. If yes, I will call this perform move, and after a second, this animation should be over. So I need to reset the animation. So I will use this dot set state, and in this set state, I do not need to pass the entire 5 parameters, the 5 states, because I just want to change the animate. So this is a good thing of this dot set state function. Animate will be false because 1 second has been passed. Now animation should stop. This looks good. Okay. Stone, paper. Okay. This is not looking good. Not sure why. Stone, paper. Okay. I'm not sure why this is happening. Let's change the keyframes. Instead of minus, let's go back and forth between 0 and 5. Let's see how that looks. Yes, this looks more promising. Stone, paper, scissors. Stone, paper, scissors. Okay, instead of going down, this is going down and coming up. So let's change everything to minus 5. This should look good. Yes. Paper, scissors. Stone, paper, scissors. Stone, paper, scissors. So instead of oscillating like this, I'm oscillating like this. Like 0 and 5, minus 5. Going back and forth. This is looking less robotic now. And the score is also getting updated. Yes. So after a second, the entire perform move logic is getting called because of this set timeout function. So we have setting this animate to be true and putting this stone user and stone to perform an animation. And after a 1000 millisecond, that is a 1 second timeout, this animation will be reset and this perform move, the entire logic that we have written, will be called after a second. So this is why you can see the score is also getting updated after a second. And now why we have included this if statement, you can see the animation was going on and I clicked the reset button in between that. So I do not need to perform this move once I have reset everything. Yay, we have received an achievement, React State of the Art. And by this, we have completed our entire project. You can verify this app is working even in mobile phones. This will be working. The same animation will be happening in our mobile phones as well. As you can see, the app is working. This reset button is also working. And now you might consider this is a complete and this will be the last video. No. Once you have a project, it is of no use if you are keeping that project in your local computer and if you are hosting that on localhost. The main thing is to deploy it online so that other people can see what you have done. So in the next video, we will make final changes to the app, like the React app title and other things, other little minor things, and deploy it online. And this deploying is completely free. So click the subscribe button to not miss out that future video. If you have enjoyed the video, please do like the video. Comment any feedback that you have for this video. You can connect to me via LinkedIn, whose link is in the description. Here are some other videos and playlists that you might want to watch, and I will see you in the next video.